Good morning, Karen, and good morning to all your viewers.
All right, we saw, of course, the press conference of Vice President Leni Robredo yesterday, thanking the public and considering this affirmation, thanking the Supreme Court for this affirmation as well. But the Marcos camp is not accepting this decision as it's over. In fact, they say that the third cause of action, the annulments of votes in Mindanao, may not be included in the decision of the Supreme Court.
Well, based on the dispositive portion that was quoted in the press release of the Supreme Court, it's very clear that the entire election protest filed by former Senator Bongbong Marcos has been dismissed. So, of course, the former senator has remedies available to him under the rules and under the law, and he can avail of them.
Yeah, and I think it's important in layman's terms to make the public understand, while there are three, there were three causes of action, they all fall under one protest.
Yes. When former Senator Bongbong Marcos filed his election protest, he alleged three causes of action. Yung una po is yung he was questioning the entire election system, and that was dismissed after the conduct of the preliminary conference. Yung second, pinapili po siya ng tatlong pilot provinces to show na may dayaan nga, according to the allegations, para mapatunayan niya na nagkaroon ng dayaan. And yung dayaan na nangyari nung 2016 elections for vice president affected the results of the election na dapat siya talaga yung nanalo. So based on the three provinces, nagkaroon ng bilangan, and instead of the votes increasing, ang nag-increase yung boto po ay for Vice President Robredo. Her votes increased by 15,000.
At palagay po ninyo, attorney, nung lumabas ang resulta doon sa sinasabing, kasi ang sinasabi ng kampo ni Marcos, hindi naman talaga yun yung second cause of action nila eh. Pero nung lumabas ang bilang doon sa pilot areas, na kumbaga lumamang pa si Robredo, imbis na nakabawi po si Marcos, naniniwala kayo ito ang naging basihan sa desisyon ng Korte Suprema na i-dismiss na ang buong protesta?
Opo, kasi right from the start, after po ng magbilangan on the three pilot provinces, we have always insisted on the application of Rule 65 of the Rules of the Presidential Electoral Tribunal. Mm-hmm. Na hindi naman po unique yung rule na to eh. This has been applied in other election protest cases pending before the Commission on Elections, mm-hmm, sa HREP, and even sa Senate Electoral Tribunal. Kasi nga, lalo na po dun sa ibang protesta na tatlong taon lang ang pinag-uusapan natin. Mm-mm. So kinakailangan mapatunayan agad ng protestant or nung naghahabol na nagkaroon ng dayaan, para din matapos na rin yung questions or doubts on the legitimacy of the victory of the proclaimed winner.
No.
So dito po, under Rule 65, pinapili ng tatlong probinsya si Ginoong Marcos. And ang pinili niya is, hindi rin po natin alam kung bakit, but the known bailiwicks of Vice President Robredo.
Oo. Palagay niyo po ba ito pagkakamali sa strategiya ito? Kasi nung when I interviewed Attorney Romulo Macalintal before, many months back, he couldn't believe that they chose those provinces.
I will not speculate on that. After all, I respect Attorney George Garcia. Mm-mm. He's a well-known election lawyer. I have been up against him in other election cases. So, decision po nila yun, we respected that decision.
Okay. Ang argumento naman po ng kabilang kampo ay hindi naman daw po recount ang gusto nila dito sa mga presinto sa Mindanao. Ito naman po ay annulment ng eleksyon dito sa tatlong probinsya. Itong Maguindanao, Lanao del Sur at Basilan, dahil daw po hindi lang sa dayaan kundi maging incidents of terrorism. So, Attorney Vic Rodriguez said they're two entirely different causes of action. This one is not about who's going to have more votes or recounting votes. It's to annul votes in those particular precincts.
Opo, pero klaro naman po ang rules na kailangan muna niyang mapatunayan na nagkaroon ng dayaan doon sa tatlong probinsya na pinili niya bago po mag-proceed ang protesta.
Parang condition po yun.
Yes, and na-dismiss na nga yung first cause of action niya. Pangalawang beses when he said that, dito sa bilangan mapapatunayan namin na nagkaroon ng dayaan. Sa pangalawang beses, sinabi na rin ng Korte Suprema na wala kang recovery. So paano nagkaroon ng dayaan? In fact, instead na madagdagan ang boto po ni former Senator Marcos, ay ang nadagdagan na boto ay for Vice President Robredo. So that's twice already that his causes of action in the election protest has been dismissed or denied by the Presidential Electoral Tribunal. So that's two out of three.
What about Rule 70? Ito ang binanggit ni Attorney Vic Rodriguez. He says Rule 65 is not applicable to them.
How can it not apply to them when the case has been lodged before the Presidential Electoral Tribunal? Rule 65 applies to the election protest they submitted to the jurisdiction. So, bakit ngayon po sila magre-reklamong hindi pwedeng i-apply ang Rule 65 sa protesta? And tulad po ng sinabi ko kanina, itong Rule 65 hindi naman po sa ginagamit sa Presidential Electoral Tribunal lang. Sa ibang protesta, pending before other tribunals, even before the Commission on Elections, ginagamit din po siya na kinakailangan mamimili muna ang protestant or yung naghahabol at mapatunayan niya dun sa mga pinili niyang presinto or probinsya na nagkaroon ng dayaan bago mag-proceed ang protesta.
Okay. And it's quite clear, no, that you said, of course, all of us still need to see the actual decision. You have not seen it, no, the camp of the Vice President too?
Not yet.
So all of us have to see it to understand in great detail how the justices actually decided. But just for hypothetical reasons, the camp of Senator Marcos said that it would be easy to annul an election just because they have the evidence to show that there were incidents of terrorism and fraud in these areas. Ang tanong niyan, ganun ba kadali talaga yun?
Hindi po ganun kadali, and we have pointed that out also in before the Presidential Electoral Tribunal. What he was mentioning about the technical examination, even COMELEC in their comment filed when the PET asked them to comment, said that it's not conclusive. Kasi yung sinasabi po niyang technical examination na ginagamit nilang basihan para makumbinse ang justices na kinakailangan mag-proceed sa third cause of action, even COMELEC is saying na it's unique to the case, that's one, and two, that was never confirmed by the COMELEC.
Okay, let's go behind the scenes. Yesterday, I think one of the members of Vice President Robredo's staff posted a photo, I think on social media or on Facebook, where all of you were watching the Supreme Court read the decision live. You were there, Attorney?
No, I was not there.
Or you were on the way?
I was actually in my office. We were all waiting for confirmation that the election protest has been dismissed.
Okay. Now, were you all surprised? I mean, I asked Attorney Vic Rodriguez. He said they had an inkling a decision would come out. But clearly, did you expect that it would be yesterday in that manner?
Actually, no. We were all surprised that there was an announcement from the spokesperson of the Supreme Court dismissing the election protest. Few weeks before, there were already speculations. We've been reading about speculations that a decision will come out, but we had no idea also on what the decision will be.
Okay. And well, is there anything I guess you'd like to add? How does the team feel at this point? I mean, clearly it was an uphill climb. Does the team feel that it's over on your end? Because clearly for the Marcos camp, it is not yet over.
Well, we all feel relief and gratitude, of course, for the justices upholding the rule of law. And at the same time, we are grateful, of course, that that the victory of Vice President Robredo during the 2016 elections has been affirmed by the Supreme Court. Mm-mm. So we can now put this behind us. After all, the confirmation of her victory did not come just once when she was proclaimed during the 2016 elections, twice when she was by the results of the recount when her votes increased by 15,000, and now for the third time, it's being confirmed by the Supreme Court when the election protest is dismissed.
Yeah. Now, to win by one or two votes is one thing, but to win unanimously is a whole other victory. Was the vice president shocked, and your whole team, frankly, given that many members were appointed by President Duterte himself? I'm sure that many of you didn't expect at least a unanimous vote.
Yes, we were all surprised when there was an announcement that it was by unanimous vote that the protest was dismissed without the dissenting opinion.
Mm-mm. Okay. All right. And why do you believe is that, other than the evidence at hand?
Well, as in with any election protest, of course, you have there 15 justices with different opinions. So we were hopeful that we were always hoping that the justices will rule in our favor and see light in our arguments. But of course, until you get the decision, you can't be 100% confident of the outcome of any case.
All right. Attorney Bernadette Sardillo, thank you so much for your time this morning. I appreciate it. You take care of yourself. God bless you.
Thank you.
All right. And I guess we're going to take a quick break and back to more news.